Ladies and gentlemen, we're kicking straight off here with Nightmare making his way down to the ring. You know, we got a scheduled match here tonight. We're going to find out what it is in just a second, but you know, we got to do the credits. We got to do the intro. Here we go. Ladies and gentlemen, we are back, and Mike the Viper Jacobs is making his way down to the ring. That is right, we are opening tonight's show with Mike Jacobs versus Nightmare. This is a main event caliber match, and we are opening the freaking show with it, ladies and gentlemen. Former World Heavyweight Champion, former Tag Team Champion, Nightmare. Former Internet Champion, Mike the Viper Jacobs. You know, these are two of the highest rated guys on the freaking roster. And they are opening the show, setting the tone for Shockwave 36. This show is going to blow your socks off. If this first match is anything to go by, you know, I haven't seen the rest of the card, but from what the owner's been saying, he's got a lot lined up. Ladies and gentlemen, let's get this show on the freaking road. Right now, we are kicking off with this match. Nightmare Mike Jacobs. You know, the owner made this match because of what happened last week. Mike Jacobs attacked Dr. Korn from behind after the match, which was Nightmare versus Dr. Korn to crown third and fourth place in the Demolition Series. Mike Jacobs came down, attacked Dr. Korn. Nightmare turned around as he was leaving the arena, or leaving the ring area, and he saw Mike Jacobs attacking Dr. Korn, and Nightmare ran down to make the save. You know, not something you'd imagine Nightmare to do. He ran down and made the save on Dr. Korn. But then out of nowhere, A-Bomb grabbed Nightmare, dragged him out the ring, and Mike Jacobs and A-Bomb left, you know, left in charge, leaving Nightmare and Dr. Korn out cold and beaten up and left for dead. And that is why this match is going ahead. So, yeah, straight off, we're kicking the show, you know, great match so far. Mike Jacobs starting to take the dominant lead here from Nightmare, who was in control towards the beginning of the match. Jawbreaker, the textbook from Mike Jacobs. You know, he knows exactly what he's got to do, and he will choose a body point, and he will pinpoint his accuracy attacks at it, just like he did with a leg lariat to Nightmare's head and jaw area, and an elbow shot to the forehead here. Mike Jacobs in control, elbow shot to the back of the head of Nightmare. Mike Jacobs throwing some wild punches to the ribs and the facial area. Nightmare blocks a punch and hooks him in the jaw, knocks him clean off his feet, bounces him off the rope, Nightmare clothesline, driving him into the ground with all the weight of his body into a Nightmare. Look at this textbook Russian leg sweep, vintage Nightmare, vintage for the cover. 1-2 and a kick out on 2 by Mike Jacobs, not enough to keep the man down. Mike Jacobs gets up, Nightmare goes to kick him, Mike Jacobs blocks the kick, Nightmare pushes him away, clothesline, cuts his freaking head off, my god. Side headlock, Nightmare drops down, grabs the leg, dragon screw. You know, Nightmare can take anyone on in a grapple match, you know. Mike Jacobs renowned for his technicality, but Nightmare is a brawler, and he's got some of the best grappling abilities in the business. Mike Jacobs blocks the attack here, turns Nightmare around, look at that. Drops him down, shoulder-based neck breaker there, cracking Nightmare's neck. And look at this, arms around, sleeper slam, drop-down style, driving Nightmare into the mat. Mike Jacobs grabs the arm, Irish whips into the corner, runs up and follows it on, drags him by the clothesline, cuts him down to size. These two men going at each other here tonight, live on Xwf Shockwave 36, ladies and gentlemen. Side headlock, Mike Jacobs. Nightmare goes for a clothesline, but Mike Jacobs ducked it and threw him over the fireman's carry style maneuver. Short arm clothesline for Mike Jacobs, picking Nightmare up to his feet. Irish whip draws him in again, short arm clothesline for a second time. Mike Jacobs picking Nightmare up to his feet. Irish whip draws him in again, short arm clothesline for a third time. Mike Jacobs going for the cover leg hook. That's one. That's two, and Nightmare kicks out milliseconds before the two. My Jacobs staying on the attack here. These two men going at each other. Knee to the stomach area from Nightmare. Reversing the attack, draws him in. But my Jacobs with a jawbreaker again, nullifying the effort. And my Jacobs in control, slamming the head of Nightmare against the canvas. You know, vicious maneuver. But it's something which we see my Jacobs do a lot, just bludgeoning and concussing the head. Hangman elbow there, right in the jaw and throat area. Leg hook for the cover from Jacobs. One, two, and Nightmare again kicks out just before the two. Not enough to keep Nightmare down, it's going to take a lot more. Blocks Mike Jacobs' punch, shot to the head. Nightmare's chance to turn this match back in his favor. Arm over, look at that beautiful suplex, slamming Mike Jacobs down with 1,000 megatons of force. And Nightmare, look at this, arm over, leg hook, Timo suplex, capture style. Throws Mike Jacobs like a freaking rag doll. You know, when Nightmare starts applying these suplexes, you're in trouble. Into the corner. What's Nightmare got in mind? Look at this. Shot to the face. I can't even count. And Nightmare kicking him in the ribs and now choking him out with a knee. Vicious. You know, Nightmare, he was getting it handed to him by Mike Jacobs, but now he is a man that is feeling the power, feeling the environment. Look at this. Sit down, powerbomb. Oh my god. Whiplash effect. Mike Jacobs holding his spine, you know, enough to shatter your freaking discs in your back. Rolls Mike Jacobs over for the cover. That is one. That is two. This is over. That is three. Mike Jacobs kicks out a 2.9. Impressive sit-down powerbomb there from Nightmare, but not enough to keep Mike Jacobs down. Nightmare torning him up for a devastator. Jacobs is in a bad way, and he blocks it with a forearm smash. Catches Nightmare out, clothesline, knocking Nightmare off his feet. Nightmare runs in. Jacobs lifts him up, face buster, sit-down style. Nightmare holding his back, holding his face. Mike Jacobs picks Nightmare up to his feet. What's he got in mind? Look at this, knife-edge chop from Mike Jacobs, and a second one, a third one. Turns around into a neck breaker. Vintage Mike Jacobs and all. Here we go. Mike Jacobs torn in Nightmare up for a Viperplex. If he nails this, this could well be over. Nightmare, crossface! He blocked it! He reversed into a crossface and he's locking it into the center of the ring. Mike Jacobs has got nowhere to go. He's itching, he's crawling. Fingers crawling across the mat. The referee's saying, if you give up, you just gotta give up, tap out, tell me whatever. But Mike Jacobs is crawling, scratching across the ring, scratching his way to the bottom rope. Can he reach it? Nightmare applying the pressure. Look at Mike Jacobs' face. He is stressing. He is in pain. Is he gonna tap out? Mike Jacobs reaching out. Fingers stretch. He's trying to reach it. God, he's so close. Nightmare applying the pressure. Mike Jacobs, he's there. He's crawling. He's got the bottom rope. Nightmare has to break the hold. Referee says break the hold. Nightmare, you know, he had the crossface locked in. Mike Jacobs somehow got to the ropes, but Nightmare is not letting this go. Two shots to the head. Irish whip. Mike Jacobs reverses it. Ducks down. Nightmare slams his face on his knee. Coconut crusher style. Spear from Nightmare. Out of nowhere. Spear him into the mat. Driving him down. For the one. For the two. For the three. Mike Jacobs kicks out on 2.8. What the hell? Nightmare picking Mike Jacobs up to his feet, staying on the attack. What's Nightmare got in mind? Into the corner. Oh, Nightmare, head under the arm, lifting Mike Jacobs onto the top rope. What is he doing? Look at this! Nightbreaker at the top rope. Oh my god, vicious. And now Nightmare torning Mike Jacobs up for a devastator. This is good as over. He's locked it in. The devastator up onto his shoulder. Mike Jacobs wiggles out. Crucifix pin. He's rolled him over. One, two. Mike Jacobs gets the cover. Nightmare can't believe it. He rolled out, but just milliseconds too late. And Mike Jacobs running away off the bottom rope. Look at this. Rolled out the ring and just shouting to Nightmare, I gotcha. Look at his face. He's so proud of himself because he got a cheap pin. Nightmare's face says 1,000 words. Nightmare is not happy about that defeat here tonight on Xwf Shockwave 36. A great way to open the show, ladies and gentlemen. You know, the fans seem disappointed that Nightmare lost to Mike Jacobs, but you win some, you lose some. Well, the owner's here, ladies and gentlemen, on the screen, and he says, ladies and gents, welcome to Shockwave 36. Tonight, I have set some matches up, and I think you're going to love them. We already know that Pegasus will face Bronx Bunny for the tag title's No. 1 contendership. We also already know Tobias Upson will defend the internet title against Penance. Now, also on the card tonight is Matt King versus Soon Army, No Holds Barred. Dr. Karn will be facing none other than A-Bomb. And in our main event, Luke Moynes and Damage will team together against Lord Lore and a man of his choice. Oh, and I almost forgot. Static and Havoc, could you please drop by my office ASAP? Ladies and gentlemen, please enjoy tonight's show. The owner laying down some great matches there. Let's just look at the card. Bring out the match cards here. Here we go. So Pegasus versus the Bronx Bunny. The winner becomes number one contenders for the tag division titles. Impressive match there. I'm looking forward to that. Now, we knew about this match prior. Tobias Upson versus Penance for the Internet Champion. Upson beat Nalis last week. Can he beat Penance this week? We're going to find out. Nat King versus Tsunami, no holds barred. Chaos will ensue in that match. Not for the weak-hearted. I'm looking forward to it. Dr. Karn versus A-Bomb. You know, this card is freaking stacked. That's going to be a great match. You know, we have Nightmare Mike Jacobs earlier. Dr. Karn, A-Bomb later. On our main event, I'm really looking forward to this. Damage and Loins team up. Did not expect that against Lord Lore and a mystery, you know, a mystery choice of his choosing. Or backstage here, Upson and Penance. And Upson says, tonight's your chance at this title, Penance. And Penance says, I know, man. I really appreciate these shots that you have given to me and Nalis. You know, he seems genuinely grateful. And Penance says, I know that we aren't primarily singles wrestlers, but we appreciate it, man. We really do. And Upson says, no problem. You guys have always been supportive to me, and I want to pay you back. So tonight, come at me hard and fast. Don't hold back, and let's have a match that will show the XWF fans what this title belt is all about. And Penance says, you have got yourself a deal, Upson. You have got yourself a deal. I'm looking forward to that match, you know. Last week's match against Malik was really good. And I think these two are going to put on a great match as well. And we're moving on straight into this tag team match now for the number one contendership for the tag division titles. Jamie Gregory and Ryan Moore making their way down to the ring. Pegasus are a great team. The fans are behind them here tonight. Obviously, they're going against Bronx Bunny, who aren't one of the most popular tag teams in the division at the moment after some of the tricks they've been pulling over the last few months. But I know a lot of fans are going to be wanting Pegasus to win this match and get a shot at the Birds of Prey. I think that would make a great title match at our next pay-per-view. Bronx Bunny making their way down to the ring. Look at these two. They're always ready for a fight. They're always ready to take some fists and slam them through your freaking faces. That's what Bronx Bunny do. That is what they like to do. And that is what they come to do. Bring the pain. Bring the fight. And obviously they're going to be bringing it harder than ever tonight because the number one contendership to tag division titles are on the line, and we know how much these two want their belts. They would lie, they would cheat, they would steal to get a shot at those belts. So Pegasus, be on your toes, my sons, be on your toes, because I don't want to know what Bronx Bunny is going to try and pull and win this match. That aside, I hope this is a great match. You know, the tag division titles are interesting as hell at the moment. The Birds of Prey are doing great with their run, but I'm looking forward to seeing who's really going to threaten them. Ryan Moore, Bruiser, the legal man, and Bruiser kicks him in the freaking chest like a freaking ton of bricks. Impressive. You know, this is what you don't want Bruiser to do, is get strikes on you. As soon as Bruiser gets strikes on you, he is going to wear you down, and you're going to have nothing you can do about it. Bruiser runs in for a clothesline. Ryan Moore moves out the way, grabs Bruiser by the head. Look at this running bulldog, driving the skull of Bruiser into the mat. Irish whip into the corner. A shot to the face there from Ryan Moore. Taking the fight to Bruiser. Look at this. Fair play to Ryan Moore. Tags in Jamie Gregory. Early tag. Keeping each other fresh. Holding the arm. Jamie Gregory with the double axe handle to the elbow. Great way. Great minds in the game. Brains in gear. They're working on Bruiser's arms. That's what you got to do. Bruiser is a striker. 99% of his attacks come from his arms. Jamie Gregory and Ryan Moore recognize that. That is why they nailed that double axe handle right on the elbow joint. Jamie Gregory looking on fire here tonight. As soon as he got in the ring, he's been taking this fight to Bruiser like no other. Look at the spin of that heel kick in the forehead, knocking Bruiser clean off his feet. Now Jamie Gregory, Irish whip into Pegasus's corner. Pegasus are locking down, absolutely locking down Bruiser. No hope for attack at the moment. Snapmare there from Jamie Gregory off the rope. Look at that, whip over to the head. An elbow drop springboarded in by Ryan Moore. Leg hook for the cover. That's one. That's no, not even a two, and Bruiser kicks out, showing the endurance that this man has, the stamina that this man has, the resilience that this man has, and Bruiser spins around and just kicks Ryan Moore in the chest with all the force of a megaton missile. Punching Ryan Moore into the corner, Irish whip into the other corner, and now they have locked down Ryan Moore and turned the tables. They are over in the Bronx Bunny corner, headbutt in between the shoulder blades. Absolutely vicious. Skinner, now the legal man after receiving a tag. Headlock there, elbow shot to the back of the head, a shot to the head, a shot to the ribs, a shot to the ribs again. Side headlock and another elbow shot. Skinner absolutely undisciplined with his strikes. What is this? Look at that. That's not even a suplex. You know, this is a style of Skinner. He don't care what he does as long as it hurts. He doesn't care if he doesn't know how to do a suplex properly. He's going to do it however he wants to do it, and then it's going to hurt. Vicious knee shot there to the ribs by Skinner, and another one just drawing in Ryan Moore. Look at this elbow shot to the back of the head as Ryan Moore is trying to get up. Look at this. Skinner sits him up, and just an elbow shot to the back. This is what I love about Skinner, you know. He's so violent, so unorthodox in his style. Runs in for a clothesline. Ryan Moore moves out the way. Neckbreaker drop, turning the tides. Turning the tides back in his favor. Ryan Moore picks Skinner up to his feet. Clothesline. Skinner up. Clothesline again. Ryan Moore off the ropes. Crescent moon kick. Skinner goes under the arm. Hook! Right in the face. Right in the forehead. He just lays Ryan Moore out in one strong right punch. What's Skinner doing? He's turning around, working over to Jamie Gregory on the apron. Ryan Moore lay down on the mat. And look at Skinner, he's saying, come on, what are you going to do about it? What are you going to do about it? Look at Jamie Gregory, he's not happy about this. Look at his face. He is not happy. He's just being torn in up by Skinner, and Ryan Moore trying to get up to his feet. Skinner turns around, Ryan Moore pushes him back. Charmaine kicking the jaw. Jamie Gregory gets in the ring, spears Brozier off the apron. Skinner didn't see him coming. One, two, three, out of nowhere. Skinner, that's your own freaking fault, man. That's your own stupidity. Just cost you the match. Skinner got cocky, turned around and received a showman kick right in the jaw, laid him out proper good. And the Pegasus are the No. 1 contenders. Pegasus will face the Birds of Prey for the Tag Division titles at an unknown date. We don't know when, but it's going to happen. The fans absolutely on their feet for Pegasus, and that is Skinner's own stupid fault. He had a pure opportunity to get the cover on Ryan Moore after he hooked him in the jaw, but instead he decided to taunt Jamie Gregory, and, you know, his mistake has cost Bronx Bunny an important match here tonight on 36. And here we're going backstage here, the owner's office. Two people just opened the door. It's Havoc and Static, and Havoc says, "You called?" But you don't address the owner like that, Havoc. And Static says, "Yeah, what's up?" And the owner says, "What's up?" "Oh, not much. Just you two ruined the main event of an anniversary show last week. Lord versus Damage. You made it a DQ." And Static says, "I wouldn't say we ruined it. We just, you know, we made our presence known." And the owner says, "Well, this is my presence, and I'm going to make it known. You're both banned from being Lord's partner tonight. Get out of my office." Oh, they're both banned from being Lord's partner. That's hilarious. That's what you get when you go and ruin a main event of an anniversary show, but the owner laying down the lore. I love it. So tonight's main event is Damage and Luke Loins versus Lord and a partner, but it can't be Havoc or Static. That's amazing. That's their own fault. You know, that's their own fault. They've shot Lord in the foot now. What are they going to do about it? Yashi backstage here with Dave Prater. He says, "Ladies and gentlemen, Masters, I am here with Dave Prater. Dave, last week on Tremors, you won a 6-man gauntlet match to become the No. 1 contender for the Internet Championship. Next week, you will have a chance to face whoever leaves tonight as the Internet Champion. Do you believe now is your time to win the strap?" And Dave Prater says, "Yashi, I've had my eyes on that championship for a long time. I came so close to beating Mike Jacobs for it, but he just about edged me out of it. Just about. Winning this match has given me another shot, and I will do everything in my power to become the Internet Champion. So be it Upson, or be it Penance, I am coming for that title, and I am coming for it hard." And Dave Crater walks off, a very emotionally charged speech there from Crater. But up next, you know, we've got Tobias Upson versus Penance Internet Championship on the line. Dave Crater better be watching and scouting out the winner of this match. Penance making his way down to the ring now. I'm really looking forward to this match. You know, last week we had Malice versus Tobias Upson in a ladder match. That was a match of Malice's choice. And it was a great match, you know. The Internet Championship was on the line. And Malice, he went out of his way. He put on a great show. He went as hard as he could. He gave it everything he had. But unfortunately for him, Tobias Upson just about did him over on a Xwf Shockwave 35. No shame, though. Great match. And Upson is obviously a great champion so far with great title defenses under his belt. And speaking of Tobias Upson, the fans on their feet as the champion makes his way down to the ring. Look at him. A man that has really come into himself since he's won that championship. You know, he's got a lot of, He's got a lot of self-belief in him since he won that match against Mike Jacobs at Absolution. And it really shines through in his performances as he has been defending this title week in, week out against various different competitors. You know, I think Tobias Upson has a bright future here in the XWF, and this title reign has really put him on the map so far. Could he be the first man to defend that title 10 times in a row and then cash it in for a shot at the World Heavyweight Championship? Can you imagine the rags-to-riches story that Tobias Upson would write for himself if he was to defend that title 10 times, cash it in, face the World Heavyweight Champion, and win the World Heavyweight Championship there and then? You know, that would be an incredible underdog story for Tobias Upson, but let's not get ahead of ourselves. We got a match here tonight first. Internet Championship on the line. Penance versus Upson. Let's get this show on the road. Two friends locking horns here. Who's the stronger man? Upson wins, twisting the arm, drags him into a side headlock. Look at this. Penance draws him in, side headlock of his own. Upson, technicality, using his ability here to outsmart Penance. Irish whips him off the ropes, ducks under. Penance jumps over, off the ropes. Tobias Upson hip toss. Classic Tobias Upson maneuver. Waist lock here from behind. Penance turns into a side headlock. Look at this. The strength of Upson drags him away, forces him out, and draws him into a side headlock. Penance knees him. These vicious kicks to the shins. Side headlock from Penance. Look at this. Throws the arm over. Snap suplex from Penance. Great start here so far from Penance. Almost sneaking up on Upson there as he was trying to get up to his feet. Misery kick from Penance. The fans on their feet. Beautifully executed maneuver. Side headlock. Penance onto his head. And a head scissors, Harkin Rana style launch there. Penance looking very strong, drawing him in. But Upson reverses it into a jawbreaker. Reversing the effort, reversing the momentum, and turning it back into his favor. Elbow shot to the back of the head. A couple of shots to the face here from Upson. Pushing Penance into the corner. Upson lifts himself up onto the second rope. European uppercut, spin around style. Clearly taking Penance clean off his feet under the arm. Tobias Upson backdrop perfectly executed. Penance holding his back from the force here. Irish whip from Tobias Upson draws him in. Scissor sweep takedown there. A great way to wear your opponent down. Send them crushing down to the mat like a ton of bricks. Enziguri step up style. Tobias Upson dragging out all the moves from his repertoire here against Penance. Throws him into the Irish whip into the corner. Goes to kick and Penance reverses it. Throws him into the corner. Grabs his arm. Penance up onto the rope. Bouncy, bouncy, bouncy. Backflip there. Japanese arm drag. Throwing Tobias Upson down. Penance's moveset. So innovative. So unique. I love it. Up onto the shoulders. Hurricane Runner again. Penance bringing out everything he's got here tonight with the Internet Championship on the line. Russian leg sweep. Whiplash in the head. Tobias Upson into the mat, lateral press cover, 1, 2, and a kick out on 2 by the Internet Champion. Not enough to keep him down, but Penance looking very strong. Picks Upson up to his feet, throws him over the top rope, goes to grab him. Tobias Upson, forearm smash. Oh, here he goes, springboard spin in, round, cross body style maneuver, something which we see Upson use a lot for the cover, 1, 2, and a kick out on 2 by Penance. Not enough to keep him down. You know, this is a guy that has a taste for the Internet Championship. He's not about to go down easy. Nice belly-to-belly, sideward-facing style there for the cover. 1, 2, and a kick out on 2 by Penance. These two going at each other. Upson goes for a kick, spin around, over the leg kick there from Penance, who's now turned the momentum back in his favor. Irish whip, crescent moon kick, knocking Tobias Upson off his feet. Penance stay on the attack, giving him no breathing room. Lifts him up, and again a crescent moon kick, drawn in style. Penance again staying on the attack, goes for the Irish whip, but Upson reverses it this time and runs in a bulldog, a running bulldog, crushing the face and skull of Penance into the mat for the cover. 1, 2, 3, and a kick on a 2.5, but Penance not enough to keep him down, but Upson staying on the attack. The momentum is in his favor this time. Irish whip into the opposite corner, runs in, drop kick in the face, and Penance just crumbles down to the mat like a sack of spuds for the cover. That is 1, that is 2. That is a kick out on 2.5 again by Penance. Not enough to keep him down. Competitive battle here from these two men. Upson turns Penance around into the corner. Moves him up onto the top rope. Penance kicks him away. What's Penance got in mind? What's Penance diving onto the Hurricanrana? Slams him down. Hooks the legs for the 1, for the 2. And a kick out on 2 by Tobias Upson. Not enough to keep the Internet Champion down here tonight, ladies and gentlemen. The Penance under the arm. Look at this spin around backdrop. Driving Upson hard into the ground. Penance picks him up. Back fist spinning style there. Kick to the side of the head. Kick to the ribs there. Pairs with a combination kick to the forehead. Laying him out. Now he's doing the two-step. He's doing a two-step. He's lining him up for a hate crime. This could be over. Tobias Upson catches him off guard with a clothesline. And another one off the ropes. Crescent moon kick from Tobias Upson. you know, the momentum almost in the favor of Penance, but Upson, acid trip, he slams him down. This could be over. Upson picking him up. Wait, Penance just reversed it, a kick to the stomach. High octane energy from these two men. Dropkick to the chest cavity. Dropkick to the forehead from Penance. Penance running in. Upson kicks him in the stomach. He turns him around, locks in the arms. Upson down, out of nowhere, totally catching Penance off guard. He rolls him over the left hook. That's one, that's two, that's three. Tobias Upson. He retains the Internet Championship here tonight on Shockwave Episode 36, putting his 10 defense status at 6 title defenses. Impressive. Look, a handshake there out of respect. Penance leaves the ring. You know, I don't think he was expecting that Upson down out of nowhere, but Upson had him scouted. He had him scouted, and just as Penance thought he had it in the bag, Upson walked him straight in with the Upson down, drove his skull into the mat, and it was over. Ladies and gentlemen, still your Internet Champion, Tobias Upson. A great match. Penance, you know, that's a great match to have under your belt, man. Great match. Matt King now on the screen, and he says, "Soon Army, you think what you did to me last week was smart? I find it funny that both you and Big D are 3 times the size of me. But the only thing that you can do to me, the only time you can get one up on me, is from behind. Well, let me tell you this. I ain't scared of either of you. I have taken on guys twice your size by the bucket load, and each time I came out on top. So once I slay you, David will go for the other Goliath, Big D. I will take back that belt that belongs to me, the Supernatural. See you in the ring tonight, Tsunami." Or backstage now with Static and Lord Lore, and Static says, "Lore, I finally found you. Your tag match tonight, the owners banned me and Havoc." And Lord Lore says, "That's pathetic. Who am I going to have as my partner then?" Oh dear. And Static says, "I've got no idea. Matt King? You know?" And Lord Lore says, "Matt King's already booked. Damn it, don't worry, I will sort something out." And Lord just, look at that, he's not happy with Static. He's not happy. It's not even Static's fault, but it is technically, but you know, it's the owner's doing. That's what you get, Static. That's what you get. Should have left Lord Lorne Damage to have a fair match on 35. But the Supernatural Matt King now making his way down to the ring. You know, if you got a faint heart, I suggest you don't watch this match, because Matt King, one of the greatest hardcore icons in E-Fed wrestling history, going on a match, a no-holds-barred match against the colossal Tsunami, a man that has brutalized so many people in the past. He has decimated people. He has sent them to hospital. He has ruined them. He has crushed them. He has put his foot on their head like it was a can of frickin' soda, and he has stomped it down into a nice compact size of aluminium crunch. And that is what Tsunami does to people, and that is what Matt King is lined up for. But if anyone is going to take the fight to Tsunami like no other, it is Matt King. You know, like Matt King said earlier, he's taken on people the size of Tsunami by bucket load, and he has come out on top every single time. Will Tsunami be added to the list of Matt King's conquests or not? We're going to find out right now. No holds barred. If you got children watching, cover their eyes. If you got children watching and don't want their eyes covered, kick them out the front room, because they do not want to see what is going to happen between these two men. Tsunami making his way down to the ring. You know, his first match in a long time. He made a well-received return on our anniversary show, last show, Xwf Shockwave 35, when he showed up and he gave the title slam to Matt King on the stage. And that is why this match has been set up, you know. Tsunami obviously wants his way back in to the no-holds-barred division, currently being ruled by the champion Big D. Tsunami is certainly a guy that, if he's in the division, all eyes are on this guy. Whether you're the champion, whether you're a challenger, whether you're at the bottom of the ladder, your eyes are always going to be on this guy, because he is a man that makes a difference to the division that he is in, and that is the no-holds-barred division. Matt King, though, like I say, he always wants to be the number one contender. He doesn't care who's in the division. He wants to be the champion, or the man that is taking the championship belt from the champion. That is the mindset of Matt King, the Supernatural. It always has, and it always will. These two men now rocking in, and Tsunami just kicks him off his feet. The power that is Tsunami. Elbow shot to the back of the head. Matt King standing Tsunami, headbutting him. Oh my God, just knocking him off his feet. You know, Matt King, you're talking about taking on guys twice the size. You better start doing something quick or this match is not going to last long. Look at Tsunami, lift the strength. Just throwing Matt King like a rag doll into the corner. Tsunami runs in and clotheslines him. Matt King just crumbles to the mat. Absolutely vicious. Irish whip into the opposite corner. Tsunami goes for a clothesline. Matt King moves out the way. Goes for a punch. Tsunami blocks a headbutt. Matt King trying to fight back, but his efforts are nothing. His efforts are pathetic. Tsunami throws him over the top rope. Punches him. Matt King falls out the ring. Oh my God. Tsunami, an absolute machine, twisting the arm of Matt King. Look at this, he grabs him and slams him down, using the weight of his body to just drive him into the ground below, throws him into the audience barrier. This is not looking good for Matt King. Headshot there, with his own head as a battering ram. Tsunami doesn't even flinch, and he's going under the ring already. Oh my God, he's got a chair. Matt King up to his feet. What's he now? Oh my God, crashing moon kick. 50 miles an hour, knocking Tsunami down. Matt King fighting back. Look at this, kick Tsunami in the chest. Slams him down face first onto the chair. Matt King innovating. Tsunami got up to his fucking feet. Matt King swung a chair. Tsunami blocked it. Just runs in. Oh my God, he just crunches him over the head. Matt King drove his head into a chair. And Tsunami just got up like a freaking fly, drove onto his face, and he just swatted it. Oh my God, a kick to the side of the head over the apron. Tsunami is an elf. He's got a freaking table. Tsunami, you know, what is he gonna do, man? Tsunami is just unstoppable. He's unstoppable. Matt King off the drop kick off the top rope. You know, you gotta give it to Matt King. He's doing everything in his power to fight this machine, this monster, this beast, this titan, this giant. He's doing everything he's got. He's giving it everything he's got. And Matt King, he ain't got no fear. He's not backing down. Into the corner, runs in across body. Tsunami falls down. You know, Matt King's starting to make leeway here. Starting to cover ground. Starting to make footsteps against this machine that is Tsunami. Matt King is fighting like no other. Goes for a kick. Tsunami blocks him and clotheslines him down. My God. Matt King valiantly fighting, giving it everything he's got, and Tsunami just cuts the momentum like that. Irish whip into the corner, Matt King move out the way. Tsunami runs in, and Matt King moves out the way, and Tsunami goes straight through a table that he set up himself. Matt King fighting back, look at these shots to the face. Side headlock from Matt King, elbow shot to the back of Tsunami, punching him into the corner, punching him again. Matt King grabs him by the head, runs, bulldog from Matt King. Fighting back, fighting against the monster, fighting against the machine, the one, the two, and a kick out on two by Tsunami. Not enough to keep him down. What has Matt King got to do? He picks Tsunami up to his feet. Matt King standing on the attack. Irish whip draws him in. Crescent moon kick from Matt King. Exactly what he's got to do. You know, Matt King said he would take the fight to Tsunami. He wasn't lying. And another crescent moon kick. You know, whether you got respect for this man or not, you can't deny that he is fighting this monster. He's giving it everything he's got. Leg hook, that is one. That is two, not even a two. And Tsunami kicks out. Matt King must be thinking, what the hell have I got to do? Punching Tsunami, fighting Tsunami, goes to elbow and Tsunami blocks it. Runs in a kick to the stomach. Matt King goes flying. Oh my God, and Tsunami just down on his knees, just punching the hell out of Matt King's face. This is no hose barred. Oh my God. Oh my God. What? Oh my, Tsunami is just feral. He's just a machine. No heart, no soul. Look at that, just throwing punches. You're gonna kill the guy, man. You're gonna kill the guy. Just oh my God, he's still freaking hitting him. My God, he's gonna kill him. Referee gotta stop the match. He gotta stop it, but he can't because there's no holds barred. You know, Matt King signed up for this. Tsunami finally stops. Oh my God, look at Matt King's head. Look at Matt King. He's freaking bleeding all over the show. Tsunami split the head out of his... Oh, my God. Tsunami. Oh, my God. This guy is a machine. And Tsunami's... Where is he going now? Just pin him. You've killed the guy. Just pin him. And Tsunami... Oh, he's got another table. He would, wouldn't he? Oh, my God. Matt King, you know, you signed up for this, man. You signed up for this. Nothing to do with me. But Big D, you better be watching this. You know, this guy wants that no-holds-barred championship, and he picks Matt King up. What's he going to do? Matt King's ready! Somehow, some way, Matt King fighting back with everything he's got. Look at him, he's dazed, he's dizzy, he doesn't even know where he is, but somehow he hit the Serenity for the cover. That is one, that is two, that is three. Tsunami kicks out of Serenity, my God. Matt King, desperation, somehow dug deep. After all of that power, all that pain, he fought back and now he is going. He's trying to win this match. A kick to the stomach. Irish whip, drop kick to Tsunami. Tsunami up to his feet, drop kick again. Matt King runs in. Tsunami just picks him up and throws him. Oh my God, 9 feet in the air. I swear to God, ladies and gentlemen. He's just dragging him along the mat. Tsunami's not even dazed. You know, everything Matt King does on Tsunami, just he doesn't look... Oh, my God, what's he doing? He's locked him into a powerbomb. That's 8 feet. Oh, my God, a powerbomb through that table. Oh, my God. So powerful. So much force for the cover. 1, 2, 3. Tsunami defeats Matt King, the supernatural here tonight. Supernatural powers could not save him from the beast that is Tsunami. Look at this replay. Look at this powerbomb. Matt King bleeding all over the show. Tsunami... That powerbomb on his shoulders, you know, Tsunami 7'2" or maybe more, I don't know. Extra high to that powerbomb, 8 foot, I would say, and he just slammed him down through the table. Tsunami torn in the fans. You know, this guy is going to be off the big day. And speaking of big day, he's on the stage. He's on the stage with that no-holds-barred title in his hands, and he's just staring down at Tsunami. Look, Big D ain't scared of him. Big D is not scared of him. He has seen what he can do. You know, Big D has lost to this guy before. He has lost to him before. But this time, he is staring him in the eyes. You know, showing, I am not scared of you this time. Big D squaring up to him from distance. And Big D leaves with that no holds barred championship. Tsunami still looking on. Ladies and gentlemen, it's only a matter of time before these two colossal titans collide. And oh my God, I am looking forward to it. Impressive match. You know, Matt King gave it his all. Not quite enough tonight. Tsunami comes out on top. And look at this. Luke Loins backstage approaching Damage. And he says, Damage. And Damage says, what do you want, Loins? And Luke Loins was saying, I was just checking up if you're ready to get in the ring tonight. You know, after that beating that you took last week, I wasn't sure that you'd be ready. Thought I'd have to, you know, go out there alone. That's a bit cheeky from Loins. A little bit of a cheap shot. And Damage says, you think you saved me, don't you? I don't need your help. I don't need help from no one. And Luke Loins says, well, it certainly didn't look that way last week. Looked like you were getting pasted into the ground. And Damage says, well, I had it all under control. I don't need the likes of you saving me. I'll watch my own back. And for your information, I'm fine for tonight's match. I'm going to go out there, do what I do best. Win, leave. And then all my focus is on that belt that's round your waist. And Luke Loins says, I expect nothing less. And Luke Loins leaves. So I feel a bit of friction between these two guys. You know, they got a team up tonight in the main event against Lord Lore and a partner of his choice. I still feel friction. You know, after all, that's the champion and the number one contender. A-bomb now. And he says, so up next, we have me, the Human Demolition Yard, versus Dr. Karn. And I can hear the XWF fans chanting Karn's name every night, wearing Karn shirts, holding Karn signs. Well, I hate to be the bearer of bad news, but tonight, I am going to run through Karn. I'm going to burn your hero in front of your very eyes. And I'm going to leave nothing for broken remains and ashes. So Karn, you better be ready for the physical power of A-Bomb Aaron Brace. And you're going to see why I got the name A-Bomb. A-Bomb laying down the lore there to Dr. Karn. I'm looking forward to it. That is up next. Dr. Karn versus A-Bomb, you know, sort of trading enemies here. Dr. Karn feuding with Mike Jacobs, Nightmare feuding with A-Bomb. And on tonight's show, we sort of swapped the opponents around. I see what the owners did there. Interesting, Nightmare took on Mike Jacobs. Mike Jacobs won. And now, up next, A-Bomb versus Dr. Karn. And who's going to win? We're going to find out. But A-Bomb making his way down to the ring. You know, this is going to be good match. I'm looking forward to it. You know, A-Bomb brings the powerhouse. Dr. Karn, he brings the skills, the wise, the guile. You know, I'm looking forward to seeing what these two have got on the line. A-Bomb, very confident. He sounded very confident with what he was saying to Dr. Karn. But can he back it up tonight here on XWF Shockwave 36? Thank you so much, everyone, for tuning in. You know, you're always amazing. Thank you for leaving comments and stuff. I want to hear what you guys think of the show. But, I am really looking forward to this match. As soon as I saw it on the card, this was maybe the standout match for me. So far, it's been a great show. You know, you can't take anything away from the matches we've had so far. Pegasus really did well winning that match. I'm surprised with that. Upson and Penance, great match. Matt King, Tsunami, great match. Nightmare and Mike Jacobs were opening the show. Incredible, great match there. And now, obviously, we got this, and we still got the main event coming up. I'm really looking forward to it, ladies and gentlemen, as I'm sure you are. But A-Bomb just torn it in the ring now, and it's surely only a matter of minutes here before Dr. Karn makes his entrance. And there we go, the fans on their feet. Dr. Karn making his way down to the ring. Look in his eyes. Seriously, look at Dr. Karn. That is the face of a man that is focused and ready to lay down the cane here tonight on Xwf Shockwave 36. If you remember last show on our episode 35 anniversary edition, Dr. Karn and Nightmare were left for dead, essentially, by the likes of A-Bomb and Mike Jacobs. So Dr. Karn is not going to be in a good mood here tonight. And especially after A-Bomb said them words about Dr. Karn earlier on, said he was going to burn him down in front of all his fans. You know, Dr. Karn is going to be anything but happy and anything but nice here tonight against A-Bomb. The fans already got a Dr. Karn shine going. You know, Hall of Famer, the only Hall of Famer here in the XWF so far. Can A-Bomb beat him? It would be massive for his career if he could. We're going to find out. These two men locking horns. Who's the stronger man when it comes down to pure brute force? A-Bomb. Side headlock with Dr. Karn, a technical man. Twists the arm, reversing it, and a punch to the elbow. Again, these men locking horns. Who's the stronger man? Brute force. Dr. Karn beats A-Bomb. But A-Bomb needs his way out. A clothesline, oh my god. Knocking Dr. Karn off his feet and a second time. The power of A-Bomb discus clothesline. Cleanly taking Dr. Karn off his feet. Punching him into the corner. Shoulder block from A-Bomb. And another one. This is the brute power of A-Bomb. Irish whip here. Launching Dr. Karn into the opposite corner. Runs in for a clothesline. Dr. Karn moves out the way. Look at this short-arm clothesline from Dr. Karn. He can brawl you just as good as you want, A-Bomb. Dr. Karn will fight you back just as much as you want. Look at this. Punch onto the ropes. Irish whip from Dr. Karn. A-Bomb goes for a clothesline. Dr. Karn under the ropes. Bounces off the rope. Catches him off guard. Clothesline. Beautiful, beautiful move. You know, this is the precision of Dr. Karn, the professionalism, the experience of this man. He knows what he's got to do. Elbow shots to the back of the head, launching A-Bomb into the corner. Shoulder thrust there from Dr. Karn. And now just down onto one knee and another shoulder block and another one. A-Bomb into the corner and knee to the face of the grounded A-Bomb. A-Bomb trying to get up to his feet. Irish whip reversed from A-Bomb. Draws him in on a shoulder block. You know, this is like a man made of cement just crushing into you. A-Bomb elbow shot to the side of the head of Dr. Karn. Side headlock. And look at this, Goth wrench, the power of A-Bomb, just slamming Dr. Karn down with such great force. A-Bomb really taking a fight, but Dr. Karn elbows his way out. These two men locking horns, who's the stronger man? Dr. Karn again wins with a side headlock. A-Bomb twists the arm. A-Bomb trying to fight back with Dr. Karn, one of the best lockup artists in the XWF. Look at that, a little ode to Titus Valentine, almost a sort of variant of the Heartbreaker there. I love it. Irish whip off the ropes, classic Dr. Kick there, around the chest cavity, knocking A-Bomb down for the cover one. Two, and a kick out on two by A-Bomb. Not enough to keep him down, but Dr. Karn staying on the attack with the right hand there. Side headlock goes for an elbow shot, but A-Bomb knees his way out. Side headlock with an elbow shot of his own there. Now A-Bomb throwing some strikes. Look at this, rolling Karn around onto that rope and just choking him over the top rope. A-Bomb pulls the rope and launches Karn back. That is the strength of A-Bomb. If you ever try to pull a wrestling rope, let alone slingshot it with someone on it like that, A-Bomb just dropping his elbow shots to the forehead of Dr. Karn. Leg hooked. That is one. That is two. And a kick out on two by Dr. Karn. Not enough to keep him down. But A-Bomb taking control of the momentum now. Bounces Karn off the rope. Karn under the arm. Under the arm. German suplex Dr. Karn. Fans on their feet. Karn picks A-Bomb up. Knee shot to the face. Whatever you do, Dr. Karn has a freaking answer for it. You know, that's the reason he's been at the top of the game for so long. That is one, that is two, and a kick out on two by A-Bomb. You know, A-Bomb, great resilience, great endurance, but now Dr. Karn using another classic Karn move, the grounded bear hug to squeeze the air out of A-Bomb. He pushes him down, and now Karn picking him back up to his feet. Side headlock, what Karn got in mind. Look at that, slams the face of A-Bomb onto his knee, and Dr. Karn under the arm, backdrop. Great combination of attacks there. A-Bomb trying to get up to his feet, but he is busted. Leg hook, that is one, that is two, that is 2.5, and a kick out by A-Bomb. Not enough to keep him down, but Dr. Karn is taking the momentum back in his control, and Dr. Karn is hitting his stride. I say that as A-Bomb hits a double axe handle, and another one. Look at this, hoists up onto his shoulder and slams him down with an Oklahoma slam. A-Bomb pumped up on his feet. He picks Dr. Karn up. A-Bomb, spine buster, finish a maneuver for the cover. One, two, three, no! Dr. Karn kicked out on 2.9. Holy cow. Holy cow! Avon can't believe it, but he knows that he is in control of this match now. Fresh off a finishing maneuver, all he's got to do is keep Dr. Korn locked down, contained, and give him no chance to turn the momentum in his favor. Irish whip powerful by A-bomb, straight into the turnbuckle. Oh my god, a kitchen sink style maneuver there, right in the face. I know A-bomb picks Korn up. Look at that, it's combustion. Combustion Oklahoma slam, sit down style for the cover. The leg is hooked. That is one, that is two, that is three, and Korn kicks out again. Milliseconds before the end, milliseconds before the three. A-bomb is frustrated, you can see it in his eyes. He picks Dr. Korn up to his feet, goes for the Irish whip. Korn reverses it, throws A-bomb over, goes to grab A-bomb, forearm smash. A-bomb taking his fight to Korn like no other, gets in the ring, throws a Korn straight into a belly to belly from Korn, catching him totally off guard. Korn picks A-bomb up to his feet. What's he got in mind? Short arm clothesline from Korn. This is Korn's chance to get back in the game. Look at this, hooks the leg on A-bomb, capture suplex. You know, Dr. Korn is pumped up. He's banging his chest when he does a freaking catcher suplex on a guy the size of A-bomb. Double axe handle from Korn. The fans on their feet. Double axe handle again. He picks A-bomb up onto a shoulder on a slam of his own. Korn, absolutely on fire, and he locks it in. Dr. Lock in the center of the ring. A-bomb's got nowhere to go. Nowhere to go. No ropes nearby to get out of this hole. Korn applying the pressure. Look at A-bomb's face. Knee in the back. Crinkling up your spine. Imagine a box of biscuits and you're just stamping on them. They're just crumbling. That is what is happening to the spinal cord of A-bomb. Every single time Korn applies pressure to this submission hold, the referee says, A-bomb, if you need to give up, just tap out or give up. As Dr. Korn is applying the pressure, you can see A-bomb stressing, his arms flailing. He's almost looking like he's going to pass out at this rate. He's almost looking like he's going to pass out. Korn is applying the pressure. Could we have a submission win here tonight from Dr. Korn? A-bomb with a knee to the face. Desperation, another knee, fights his way out. But Korn straight behind A-bomb. A-bomb turns a stethoscope kick. A-bomb dazed and stunned from that move for the cover. One, two, three. Now he kicks out. Somehow, you know, A-bomb, he managed to get out of the Dr. Lock. But he was in pain. He was in agony and he got stethoscope kicked. And now Korn turning him up for a neck surgery, but a double axe handle. A-bomb fighting back at another one, slaying the doctor, puts him onto his shoulder. Doctor drops down. Operation! Operation from the doctor! This is as good as over. This is as good as over. There is no way A-bomb is kicking out of that. The leg is hooked. That is one. That is two. That is three. Dr. Korn defeats A-bomb here tonight. You know, A-bomb, he was stunned and dazed from that Dr. Lock. He got up, he got out of it somehow into a stethoscope kick. And then, you know, A-bomb was trying to fight back. He tried to do an Oklahoma slam, but Dr. Korn locked in an operation, and this match was as good as over. Dr. Korn is victorious. You cannot take anything away from A-bomb. You know, there was points in that match where he was dominating the doctor. He was dominating him, but tonight, the doctor came out on top. And still up tonight, ladies and gentlemen, our main event, Damage and Loins, the World Heavyweight Champion, and then one number one contender for the World Heavyweight Champion, go against Lord Lore and a mystery partner. It cannot be Static. It cannot be Havoc. Who can it be? We're going to find out. But ladies and gentlemen, I am looking forward to this match. And we are moving on to the main event. So let's get on this right now. Damage making his way down to the ring. The number one contender for the World Heavyweight Championship. The winner of the second ever Demolition Series here in the XWF. Damage is absolutely on fire at the moment. You know, this guy, he's got it all going for him right now. And tonight, he teams up with the World Heavyweight Champion, Luke Moynes. Now, these two guys, you know, I think between them, they could be an amazing team. Think about it. There is some friction. We're not going to lie. We saw it backstage earlier. We know Luke Moynes and Damage aren't the best of friends. But, you know, hopefully tonight they can come together and win this match against Lord Lore and a mystery partner. Luke Moynes holding the belt above his hands, above his head. The fans with their hands in the air, that's what I meant to say. You know, the fans all behind Luke Moynes as he makes his way down to the ring. Damage and Luke Moynes as a team, you know, I'm excited to see this. I've never seen it before. Like I said, these two men are arguably the best men in the XWF at the moment. That's the World Heavyweight Champion. The most prestigious title in the XWF, and that's the champion right there, Luke Moynes, and the number one contender for that title, Damage. You know, that's the credentials of these two men. and what they bring to the ring. As a team, essentially, they should be unstoppable, but if there is friction there, well, we're going to have to see. Also depends who Lord Moore's partner is. Obviously, you cannot choose Static, and you cannot choose Havoc. They've both been banned, not just from being Lord Moore's partner, but I've actually heard in my ear they're banned from ringside completely by the owner. So Lord Moore is going to have to find out, you know, if another partner. I don't know who he's got in mind, but he must have sorted something out. Lord Moore making his way down to the ring, one of the most iconic figures in EFED wrestling, a man whose domination, whose legacy precedes him here in the XWF, and yet again in the main event here tonight against Luke Boynes. These two men have crossed paths many a time. It was in fact Lord Moore that Luke Boynes defeated at Absolution for the World Heavyweight Championship, saving the XWF in the process and winning his first singles title, actually, wins the World Heavyweight Championship. So, exactly, very good for him. Hashtag Crow on Twitter. Looking like people are thinking Crow is going to be Lord Moore's partner, which isn't a bad shout, actually. And, oh, wait a minute. Wait a minute. Ladies and gentlemen, I did not see this coming. Reverend Al has returned to XWF TV. You know, this is his second ever appearance here in XWF. His first being an Absolution, where he helped Team XWA defeat Team XWF in a survival match. You know, this is the man responsible for beating Tsunami. The big blue beast we saw earlier, this man pinned him 1-2-3. You know, this guy is a legend in this industry, a man that feuded very long and hard with Lord Moore in the XWA back in the year 2006. But obviously, over years, they've come to respect each other, and tonight, Reverend Al is Lord Moore's partner. You know, incredible lineup of guys here tonight. Luke Boynes and Damage versus two veterans and legends in the industry in the form of Lord Moore and Reverend Alphonse Walker. Could be an interesting match, really interesting main event. I'm looking forward to seeing how this goes down, who's starting the match off, who's the legal man. It's Lord Moore and Damage. Lord Moore, a kick to the stomach of Damage. You know, Lord Moore, feral, he's a machine, he's a beast, he's a monster, and he's just taking the fight to Damage. Irish whip bounces Damage off the ropes, ducks under Damage off the other rope. Look at this, Damage jumps up, shoulders onto the shoulders of Lord Moore, drives his knees into the face, knocking him down. You know, these two men go back into 2007, and Lord Moore is a sort of mentor to Damage. Now they're in the main event in 2014, XWF going one-on-one in this tag team match. Irish whip into the corner from Lord Moore, goes for a shoulder. Damage moves out the way. Santon in the corner, satin down, landing on a sat down Lord Moore. Damage punches him into the corner, shoulder block here. Look at this. Damage, Irish whip, launching Lord Moore into the opposite corner. Damage runs in, goes for the knees. Lord Moore moves out the way. Sword attack coming. Elbow shot to the back of the head. Big boot, knocking Damage clean off his feet. Damage trying to get up to his feet. Lord Moore punches him into the corner. Shoulder block there from Lord Moore. And another one. Winding Damage extremely. Grabs him by the arm. Irish whip throws Damage into the opposite corner. Lord Moore coming down. Tags in Reverend Alphonse Walker. Lord Moore. Irish whip. Scissor sweep. Damage crumbles to the mat. Elbow drop to the back of the head and shoulders from Reverend Al. Reverend Al in the ring. Look at this German suplex. Throwing Damage. My God. Nobody hits German suplexes like the Reverend Alphonse Walker. Reverend picks Damage up to his feet. Irish whip. Damage taking a little bit of a bruise in here. Ducks under Damage. Damage off the ropes. Hip toss there from Reverend Al with great force. Pneumatic force. Lord Moore picks Damage up. Launches him into the corner with a heavy flurry of strikes. And now just throwing shoulders into the abdomen of Damage. And just stomping a mud hole and choking him out with the knee. Choking him out with the knee. Reverend Al picking Damage up to his feet. Irish whip. Reverend Al and Lord Moore locking Damage in their corner. Damage double feet his way out. A Busaki knee kick there, knocking Reverend Al off his feet. And a second one. Reverend Al trying to get up to his feet. And a beautiful kick to the side of the head from Damage, starting to turn the tables in his favor. European uppercut. Side headlock. Goes for another one. Reverend Al spins it out. Turns it into his own methodical assault. But Damage fighting back. Launching. Oh, look. What the hell? Damage throwing him through the hole. Look at Luke Loins. Damage looking at Luke Loins. Using Luke Loins' maneuver, the rope hung DDT. That is a move that Luke Loins uses all the time. Damage looked over in his direction before he used it, almost cheekily. Say, look at what I'm doing your move. Going for the 10 punch here. Damage just throwing punches into the score for Evan Dow. Look at this, going for the 10. Hold his arm up and he punches it and he nails it. And Reverend Dow just crumbles to the mat. Damage dragging him away from the corner. Could this be over? Gets the leg hook. That is one. That is two and a kick out on two by Reverend Dow. Not enough to keep this guy down. Damage going for a punch there. Side headlock, European uppercut. And again, Damage grabbing the arm. Draws him in, but Reverend Dow reverses it to a kick, abdomen kick. Throws the arm over his head. Reverend Dow starting to turn this back into his favor with a methodical, beautifully executed suplex of precision. Look at this, twisting the arm, kicks Damage down. DDT from Reverend Dow. Crushing the skull, beautiful for the cover. That is one, that is two. And Luke Loins came in there. Luke Loins came in as if he was, you know, if he underestimated Damage could kick out with that maneuver. Elbow shot to the back of the head. A second one followed up by a third, but Damage reverses it. Reverend Dow, one of those technical guys in the profession. Don't try and out-technicalize the guy. Elbow shot to the back of the head of Damage. I think Reverend Dow is going to go for it again. Damage kicks him in the midsection and drives his head into his knee. Damage is punching Lord Law off the apron. Damage is on fire. You know, Reverend Dow had the upper hand of this battle between these two men for a long time there. And now Damage is finally taking back control, driving the knees into Alphonse Walker's forehead. Picking Alphonse up, driving a knee into his skull. Damage on fire here. Look at this. He picks Alphonse up to his feet, drags him over. Luke Loins tags him on the shoulder there. I don't think Damage wanted a tag there. But these two men, oh, look at this. Look at the fans on their feet. Double suplex from the world heavyweight champion and the No. 1 contender. What a moment. What a moment. Luke Loins for the cover. That is one. That is two, and a kick out on 2.3 there by Reverend Dow. Not enough to keep him down, but now the world heavyweight champion is in the ring, and he is taking this fight to Reverend Dow. Irish Whip draws him in a short arm clothesline, driving him into the mat. Luke Loins picks him up to his feet. Irish Whip off the ropes, but Reverend Dow hooks his arm around the rope. Professionalism and experience there at use by Reverend Dow. Reverend Dow wins the tie-up, side headlock. Luke Loins reverses it into a side headlock of his own. Reverend Dow twists the arm, never trying out, technicalize this guy. Look at this, hooks his arm around. So innovative. This guy knows every move in the book. I've never seen that reversal before, but Reverend Dow will drag it out. Shoulder block there. Going again, but Luke Loins puts a knee up into the face of Reverend Dow, throws him into the corner. Luke Loins in control here. Shoulder block to the ribs and midsection. And again, look at this. Luke Loins steps up. Velocity dropkick into the chest there, using the ropes for extra power. Luke Loins drags Reverend Dow away from the ropes. Could this be over? Luke Loins for lateral cover. One, two, and a kick out on two there by Reverend Dow. Not enough to keep the legend down. Luke Loins staying on the attack, but wait. Reverend Dow reverses it. Clothesline, and another clothesline from Reverend Dow. Luke Loins goes for a clothesline. Reverend Dow ducks on the power slam from Reverend Dow for the cover, turning the tides. One, two, three. Now a kick out on 2.5 by Luke Loins, trying to get up to his feet, but Reverend Dow starting to take control. Luke Loins went for a clothesline. Reverend Dow ducked under, fireman carry. Again, Luke Loins went for a punch. Reverend Dow pulling out every reversal in the book. Irish Whip here from Reverend Dow draws Luke Loins in. Just a casual knee to the stomach there. Flips him over, kitchen stink style. And a second one there from Reverend Dow. Lines up the face, drops a knee into the face of Luke Loins. Reverend Dow turning the tables on this match. Irish Whip into the corner. Shoulder blocking Luke Loins, and he tags in the lethal litigator, Lord Lore. Reverend Dow, Irish Whip, scissor sweep, Lord Lore, elbow drop to the back of Luke Loins' head. Oh man, you can see in Lord Lore's eyes that he wants to be in the ring. That is one, that is two, and that is a kick out on 2.5 there. Damage got in the ring as if he didn't expect Luke Loins could kick out. These two don't have much faith in each other. Knee shot to the face there from Lord Lore. You can see in the eyes of Lord Lore that he wants to take this fight to Luke Loins, the man that took the World Heavyweight Championship off him. Look at Lord Lore. Look at this, throwing the arm over. Snap suplex. It's like a shark that tastes blood in the water. It's like a tiger that sees a little deer running away wounded. Goes for another suplex. Luke Loins, knees in the head. Knees to the top of Lord Lore's head. Clothesline cutting him down to size. And another one. Luke Loins, the World Heavyweight Champion, on fire. Now look at this, spin around neck breaker. Lord Lore torned Luke Loins, and it really kicked Luke Loins off. Irish Whip into the corner. I think Luke Loins needs a tag, and he accepts that. He tags Damage in. holding the arm of Lord Lord. Damage with a double axe handle to the arm of Lord Lord. Legal man now damage. Look at this reverse hurricane runner. Oh my god. Launching Lord Lord onto his head. You know, this could be as good as over. That was an incredible move. That is one. That is two. That straight kick out on 2.9 by Lord Lord. Not enough to keep him down. The damage certainly in control as Lord Lord tries to get up to his feet. Hooks him in the side of the head again. Lord Lord trying to get up on damage. Hitting him with another shot. Lord Lord up to his feet, but damage with a side headlock. Look at this. Pulls the fist back and shuts him right in the forehead. Knocking him off his feet. And now damage Irish whip into the corner. What's damage got in mind? Look at this. Pulls Lord Lord out from the ropes. Spins around. Tornado DDT. Right slap bang out. Center of the ring for the cover. 1, 2, 3. Another kick out on 2.9 by Lord Lord. Still not enough to keep this man down. Damage torning him up for a brain damage. Luke Loyne's coming out, launches Reverend Dow off the ropes, follows him out, but I don't think he saw that Lord Lord reversed the brain damage, and he's locking in the lore breaker on damage, and he nails the lore breaker. Lord Lord for the cover. 1, 2, 3. Damage kicks out. Damage gets an arm up. I thought that was over, but somehow Damage kicked out. Lord Lord torning him up for another one. Reverend Dow takes Luke Loins out this time, but Damage kicks him in the stomach. Irish whip off the rope, drop kick in the chest cavity. Lord Lord out to feet. Damage drop kick in the jaw. Lord Lord goes for a clothesline. Damage catches the arm, twists him down, and slams him with the neck breaker. I don't know how Damage is still standing after that lore breaker. That's one, that's two, that's three, and Lord Lord kicks out. Damage somehow digging deep, finding adrenaline to still be in this fight, to still be in this battle after such a near fall. Knee to the stomach there of Lord Lord. He picks Lord Lord up to his feet. Irish whip drags him in at another one. You know, Damage is holding his head. He is in pain, he is in agony, but he is still taking this fight to Lord Lord. Goes for another one, but Lord Lord hits him with that jawbreaker, and that could be enough to knock Damage out of this match. Oh, double axe handle, and another one. Damage desperate need of a tag. Oklahoma slam, they're slamming Damage down with great force from Lord Lord. Absolutely vicious looking. Damage is in a bad way, he needs a tag. Oh no, Lord Lord lining him up for swift justice. Damage, look, he's stunned, he's dazed, he doesn't know where he is, he needs to tag, but Lord Lord has got him lined up for swift justice. Damage, you gotta find a way out. Luke Lloyd taps him on the back, blind tag. Luke Lloyd gets in the ring, Lord Lord running for swift justice, tail him back from Luke Lloyd, catching Lord Lord off guard, out of nowhere. Reverend Dow gets in the ring, Luke Lloyd turns around, signature maneuver, atonement from Reverend Dow, slamming Luke Lloyd down. Damage ain't having it, he's got in the ring, he runs over, he grabs Reverend Dow, throws him over the top rope, Al holds on, Damage close. Clotheslines him off the apron. Damage Springle shoot his star press to the outside, nailing Reverend Dow. Lord Lord's up. He picks Luke Loins up. Luke Loins tail him back out of nowhere. Lord Lord didn't see it coming. A second time. The legs hook. 1, 2, 3. Luke Loins on Damage. Do it. Luke Loins on Damage. The feet. Reverend Dow and Lord Lord here tonight on the main event of Xwf Shockwave 36. Look at this replay. Luke Loins hits the hell on back. Reverend Dow gets in, Luke Loins turns around, atonement slam there from Reverend Dow, nailing Luke Loins. Damage sees what's going on, he doesn't have it, he runs in, grabs Reverend Dow, throws him over the top rope, Al holds on, Damage clotheslines him off. Look at this springboard, shooting star press to the outside, just nailing Reverend Dow, so impressive. Lord Lord thinks he's got it in the bag, picks Luke Loins up, and like, sees the hell on back. Out of nowhere, catching Lord Lord off guard. Second one of the match for the 1, for the 2, for the 3. And Luke Loins got the cover on Lord Lord again, showing why he's a world heavyweight champion. Luke Loins celebrating, the fans on their feet. Amazing main event match there. Really enjoyed it. You know, both teams so strong. Both put out the matches of their lives there tonight. But unfortunately for Lord Lord and Reverend Dow, Luke Loins and Damage with a better man. Damage getting in the ring as Luke Loins torn in. And now these two men having a stare down. They got their hands up ready. Look at Damage staring into the eyes of Luke Loins, the world heavyweight champion, staring into the eyes, the No.1 contender. What's going to happen here? What's going to happen? All eyes on these two men. And Damage backs up and Damage jumps over the top rope. He's leaving. No handshake or nothing. No respect from these two men. Luke Loins leaving as well. He wants nothing more. Wait, Damage is running back in. He grabs Luke Loins. He turns him around. He locks him in. The brain damage. He lifts the world heavyweight champion up. Brain damage lands him on his head in the center of the ring. The fans boo him. These two men just work together to achieve a goal. And now Damage just proving that he has one thing on his mind. The World Heavyweight Championship. As he drops the World Heavyweight Champion on his freaking head. On his freaking neck. And Damage, he's got the World Heavyweight Championship in his hands. He's got the World Heavyweight Championship in his hands. And he is staring at the World Champion, who is decapitated on the floor. And Damage throws the belt down. It's not his yet. But he has left a message for the champion as he leaves, and Luke Moyes is left motionless on the floor after receiving a brain damage. A great match, but a taint on that match as Damage once again proves that he cares for no one. He works for no one. He cares only for himself. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for watching XWF 36. Please leave some comments. Tell me what you thought of the matches. Tell me what you want to know. Ask me questions. You know, I appreciate everyone who watches this show. Thank you so much. They're out.